Cosmological principle, it says that universe is homogeneous and isotropic. And yeah, that is correct. Let me see here. It doesn't say universe is stable. Now, that was a popular assumption before Hubble's discovery. And it turns out that universe is expanding. And it's a remarkable discovery because I think natural philosophers tend to prefer to assume an everlasting universe because beginning of universe is a bit problematic, and it still is. Kind of moment of Big Bang is when we think the laws of physics as we know it might not hold, which is module six topic. But so expanding universe implies a universe that was smaller in earlier time, smaller in earlier time, and you go back earlier enough, you have a time and moment that we call singularity, which might be the beginning of universe. I think it's some theorists that try to talk about like oscillating universe, but maybe that is what happened. But it, and the finding observational or experimental evidence for that is gonna be challenging. But anyways, that's not cosmological principle. It does state that, but we don't actually see this in smaller scales. Like Earth, center of Earth is very different from outer layers of Earth, even the solar system, even the Milky Way galaxy. Maybe if you go out to local group and Virgo supercluster, you begin to say, oh, no one galaxy is really much bigger than the other. But at the smallest of scales, cosmological principle is not obvious. Supported by the survey of distant galaxies. Yeah, Sloan Digital Sky Survey, there's an image of, wait, I said I wouldn't explain. That is correct. And yeah. And the core true response to this is a bit nuanced. I guess the best way to say it is that universe doesn't have a center. There's no one special location in the universe. So I mean, Milky Way galaxy has a center. We just don't happen to be there. But when you look at the entire visible universe, there's no one particular location where that we would call center. So you could actually say that, oh, then we can say Earth is at the center. Yeah, I guess. But it's a kind of oversimplification. But what it's saying here isn't wrong because there's no such thing as the actual center of universe. So